When you run into problems or start getting alarms on your Haas machine that points you in the general direction of the pneumatic system, sometimes that can lead to confusion and frustration. Now, the pneumatic system and all of these solenoids that it powers are here, of course, to control all devices on the machine that use compressed air. And when you have a problem in this region, probably the real question you're asking yourself is, do I have a problem with my pneumatic system? Or do I have a problem with my electrical system? Or do I have a problem with one of these specific solenoids right here? Well, in this video today, we're gonna help you try to clear that up. A solenoid valve is defined as an electromechanically operated valve. In other words, it's a valve that's connected to an electrical coil. And when the coil energizes, it moves the valve up and down. And that controls the flow of air to the device that the solenoid is operating. Now at Haas, we've got lots of different configurations of solenoids. Two ports, three ports, multi-port, solenoids connected to manifolds. Despite those differences, there is one way in which all of these solenoids operate exactly the same. None of them want to be hooked up to a contaminated air source. Now that's a very important topic, and we're gonna get back to that in a minute. But first of all, we need to decide if our problem on our machine is the solenoid or it's actually the system that's powering the solenoid. Generally speaking, there are two questions you have to ask yourself before you decide if the solenoid is at fault. Number one, is the solenoid receiving the correct electrical signal to turn it on and off? And number two, is the solenoid getting a sufficient amount of air, and is it getting that air in a consistent manner? Let's consider a hypothetical example. Say I'm having problems with tool clamping, and I suspect I have a problem with the TRP circuit. That leads me to check the TRP pre-charged solenoid right here. To begin with, I need to check that this solenoid is getting the proper electrical signal to turn it on and off. So I'm gonna write a simple program to make a series of tool changes so that I can check for power at the wire coming to this solenoid. I'm using this inductive voltage detector. These are great for quickly checking if you've got power. And also, there's no risk of damaging your electrical connections. These are about 20 bucks at the hardware store or online. There's a good reason we're using this voltage detector. We find that these electrical connections get damaged more often than you might think by the overzealous use of electrical probes. Jamming these probes into the connector carelessly can easily damage the pins, and that equals a bad connection. That's not good for the connector, and it also confuses the diagnostic process. With my program running, I just hold the detector right beside the wires going to the solenoid. And I can see and hear that I've got power going to the solenoid every time it fires. That means this solenoid has a good electrical connection. Now, if I didn't see voltage here, then I need to troubleshoot the wiring coming to this solenoid. So in our case, we know the solenoid is getting power. So let's move on to the air supply. You need to know that your machine is getting adequate air pressure. I'm gonna start up that tool change program again so that we can check for air pressure at our gauge right here. Now, you shouldn't see the air pressure drop below 65 PSI when the machine is changing tools. In our case, it's not going below 65, so we know we're good. So once you know your power and your air are good, then it's either your solenoid or the component that your solenoid is controlling that's your problem. So next, we're gonna move on to checking that this solenoid works correctly mechanically. If you're working in an older machine where the solenoids are not centrally located in the air loop panel, then you need to start by finding the solenoid that you need to test. Once you've correctly located that solenoid, the rest of the troubleshooting process is just the same. So we need to check that this solenoid mechanism itself is functioning correctly. Now I'll do that by using the manual override button. When I depress this manually, it moves the valve to the open position. And I can use a ballpoint pen or the round end of a hex wrench. And when I depress this, it should open quickly and crisply. And it should never be slow or sticky. And there's a quick check you can make by pulling off the exhaust outlet hose and actuating the solenoid several times. This is an easy way to make sure there's not obvious debris floating around in there that can be quickly cleared out. In our case, this machine is fine and this solenoid is actuating correctly. But we're going to stop for a minute and pretend that it's sticking and is not functioning properly. That way, we can show you how to clean the solenoid out in those cases where contamination is not too severe. But before we get started with that, we're going to stop and take a detour to discuss what's maybe the most important part of this video. And what's that, you might ask? Contamination is what we're talking about. Based on returned solenoids that Haas receives, at least 50% of all solenoid failures are due to some form of contaminated air. And there are three basic contaminants we're talking about here: oil, water, and particulate. You might ask yourself, why is it that so many compressed air installations seem to have problems with water in the airlines? The fact is that every compressed air system has the potential to have big problems with water. It turns out that your air compressor isn't just good at compressing lots of air, it's also pretty good at extracting lots of water as it's compressing that air. Consider this: a relatively small 100 CFM compressed air system running in a typical shop 5 days a week can easily generate over 2,000 gallons of water in a year. That's about 40 gallons going to the receivers and air lines all throughout the shop every week. So what's the number one cause for failure by contamination? Our testing shows that the number one reason solenoids malfunction and fail is due to contamination by oil. Oil acts as a solvent, and it causes the internal seals inside the solenoid to swell and change shape. And once the seals inside the solenoid have reached this point, there's no going back. You can take that solenoid off and try to clean it out, but most likely, your next stop is going to be HaasParts.com to get a replacement. And you might ask, where are those contaminating oils come from? They come from a wide variety of sources. Your compressor's own lubrication system can bring oil into your air system. They can be hydrocarbons brought in with the inlet air going to the compressor. Some shops choose to clean out their air systems using solvents that can damage the solenoids. And some places even hook up inline air oilers that are going to the same lines that are feeding the machines. The number two culprit for solenoid failure is water contamination. And we know the compressors make a lot of that. So why is it bad to have water in your air lines? Well, water reacts with and corrodes pretty much every metal that's typically used inside of a compressed air installation. Say you're running black pipe, for instance. Water will corrode the inside surfaces of that black pipe, and that rust will end up making its way into your machine. Also, water can corrode the internal surfaces of these solenoids. And if you leave it in that state for long enough, it can completely block off the orifices inside of these guys. So what's an easy way to see if you've got problems with water? Well, let your machine sit for a little while and then grab your air gun. And if you can see a plume of water like this, you know you've got a problem with water. And if you let your machine stay that way, then you're probably going to end up with something that looks a lot like this. This solenoid is completely blocked off by corrosion, and you're not going to be able to clean this out. Most likely, your next stop, again, is going to be HaasParts.com to get a new solenoid. But before you fit that new solenoid into your air system, make sure you take care of your water problem first. And yes, you might say, but my machine already has a water separator right here. And you're right. This unit and the purge valve that empties it work great for clearing out moderate amounts of moisture that might reach the machine. But they're not intended to handle large quantities of water. The air that's coming to your machine really needs to be dry before it gets here. And in case you didn't realize it, this water separator has an air filter in it. So if your air supply to your machine is good, but you still have issues with pressure or flow, then you probably want to open this up and clean it out in case it is clogged up with the debris coming in through your airlines. And when it comes to keeping water out of your airlines, there's lots of good information out there about compressed air system design. There are simple things you can do to make sure your system functions at its best, like always using vertical risers with drains at the bottom, and always connecting your machine drops to the top of your main air supply line So you just get the air and you leave that water behind. And that leads us to the third way in which solenoids fail, and that's through particulate. Particles coming through your air system and jamming up the works inside your solenoids. Those particles can get in there from a lot of sources. Thread sealant tape, liquid thread sealant. It can be burrs or chips that are created during the installation of your air system. And don't forget, all those corroded airlines that you can have if you have water problems, that corrosion can turn into chips that make it all the way into these solenoids here. If you're working on an older machine, then you might easily find yourself in a situation like this, where there's a ton of crud built up around the solenoid and the fittings. Before you start tearing into this system, you need to make sure that you've completely cleaned this area so you don't introduce any of these contaminants directly into the air system. If you crack this open without cleaning it, then you've just bypassed all of your external filtration. And if you're pulling apart electrical connectors in an environment like this, get them cleaned off too. And don't forget to add some dielectric grease so corrosion doesn't become an issue. We've talked a lot about contamination. Now we're back at the side of the machine where we're going to remove that solenoid for cleaning. So to get started, we'll switch off air to the machine. Then we're going to take our pen and depress the manual activation on the solenoid here and bleed that air off. I'm going to pull off my air line. I'm going to push up this conduit cover. Now I can undo the electrical connector, pull the electrical cable out of the conduit. Now with the electrical cable free, I'm ready to remove the solenoid. There's our solenoid. Let's go get this thing cleaned. With the fittings removed, you want to take a close look at your inlet filter right here. You don't want to see any particles here. If you do, remove them carefully. The best substance we've found for cleaning out solenoids is Mass Airflow Sensor Cleaner. It's available at auto parts stores everywhere, and it doesn't contain the kind of solvents that are going to damage the seals inside the solenoid. Now, we're going to use this stuff to clean the solenoid out while we're depressing the manual activation button on the top of the solenoid. You can also actuate the valve up and down manually so that you clean all the moving parts inside. So our solenoid's all cleaned out. Let's reinstall the machine and see how it works. Now there's one more check we can make on this solenoid before we finish buttoning it up, and that's to check if it's got any internal leaks. Now to do that, I'm gonna just turn the air back onto my system. Got my air pressure. Let me just check if I've got air at the solenoid. Yep, definitely have air. Now I'm just gonna take my finger and put it over the exhaust port here and hold it there for a few seconds. Now when I release my finger, there should be no built-up air pressure behind it. Now if I did have some pressure built up behind my finger, that would indicate that there was an internal leak in this solenoid. And we know we just got done finished cleaning it. So that would probably mean it was time to replace that solenoid. In our case, everything's fine, so I can finish buttoning this up. Now, if you get to a place where you've tested the solenoid for power, air, and mechanical actuation, and you're still not really sure if your solenoid has a problem or not, there's another way you can double check things. You can take another solenoid of the same style and swap it out with the one that you think has a problem. If that fixes the problem and that circuit begins to work, you can be pretty sure that your original solenoid does in fact have a problem and needs to be replaced. But if it doesn't fix the problem, then you need to go back and troubleshoot the rest of your system again to find out where that problem lies. That said, let's recap. If you've got problems with the pneumatic system or the solenoids on your machine, the first thing you need to test is, do you have a problem with your electrical system? Do you have a problem with your air source? Or do you have a problem with a specific solenoid? Once you've got that figured out, then it's time to move on and make sure that the solenoids on your machine don't have a problem in the future. You do that by making sure the air getting to your machine is both clean enough and dry enough. Thanks a lot for watching.